So in this video, we're talking about significant figures and how to round in mixed operations. That is when you have a combination of multiplication or division and addition or subtraction. So we know what to do in each of the individual cases, but what if there's both of these things going on? Well, here's what we do. This is the rule. All you do is you follow the order of operations, so you perform each step of the calculation one step at a time. And this is, I think, where sometimes people get a little bit off in this. You're so used to putting everything into your calculator at once and then just getting the answer. Well, to figure out how to round, you have to make yourself take it one step at a time. Just follow the order of operations. And at each step of the calculation, keep track of the significant figures that you're allowed to carry through. In other words, if that were the only step, where would you round there? This is where the subscripts that I use come in to be really, really useful. All right, so let's look at an example. We're assuming all of these numbers came from measurements, so they're, you know, and they're written to the correct number of significant figures. So we have 1.41 minus 0.2 divided by 7.32 plus 0.86. So the order of operations says we have to do the subtraction on top of the division first. So because we're doing the subtraction, remember the rule there is that we would round to the same place as the number that has the last significant figure farthest to the left. Well, 1.41, the 1 is the last significant figure and it's 2 to the right of the decimal. The 0.2, the last significant figure is the 2, it's 1 to the right of the decimal. That's farther to the left than this is, so we're going to round at this step to the tenths place. So there it is, we're just doing the first step, and we get 1.2 sub 1. Okay, we kept the tenths place, and we wrote the first, at least the first insignificant figure as a subscript. Remember, don't round during the middle of these operations. Keep everything in your calculator. The only time you're gonna round is at the very end. Catch that? That's pretty important. Never round until the very end. So our next step in the order of operations will be to do this division here. So because we're doing division now, the rule is whichever number has the least number of significant figures, that's how many sig figs we're allowed to keep. Well, the top number has 1, 2 significant figures. The bottom has 1, 2, 3. So we're allowed to keep 2. And so we keep 2.16. And our first, you know, I kept the first 2.53 here. Next, okay, and remember, I noticed I didn't round yet. Next, we're going to do the last step, which is the addition. And because we're adding, once more, we look at where the last significant figure is. Well, here it's 2 to the right of the decimal, the 6, right? And here it's 2 to the right of the decimal, this 6 right here. So that means we get to keep 2 to the right of the decimal. And that ends up being 1.02, first insignificant figure is a 5. And because that the first insignificant figure is 5 or bigger, we're going to round up, and our final answer will be 1.03. So notice, okay, we started out with 3 sig figs, 1 sig fig, and 3, and we ended up with 3. There's no connection between there being 3 here and 3 here. That's just chance, okay? And notice also that you can't just look at the sig figs before you start and figure out how many there's going to be in the answer. You really have to do each step one step at a time and keep track of sig figs during each step. If you do that, you'll be fine.